Hola amigos, I'm Siddhi, your very own book gobbler, and welcome to my channel where I talk about books and everything related to books. So if you love books, read books or eat books just like me, then please just subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of my videos. Now coming up with the stationery haul. It's not a huge haul, but I have gathered some stationeries from Amazon, and that's what we are going to see in today's video. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So guys, I managed to purchase some of the items from Amazon. I usually call for post-its, and post-its are the regular stationeries that I use. But apart from that, I thought of buying certain items which I really loved while browsing through Amazon, and so that's what we are going to see in today's video. So the first item that I have is stationery haul is these fair felt papers. I got this from Asian Hobby Crafts, and these felt papers I got basically for making an album book. So what I am thinking of doing is using the Polaroids of my daughter and sticking those onto these papers and making an album book of sorts, because usually the album books that we get on Amazon are priced around 400-500, and with this I could manage around 200 rupees. I think this is a better deal. Plus I get this rope kind of thing and I can tie it up, so making it, giving it a bookish feel as well. So that's my idea for buying this. The next item that I have here is these highlighters. So I'll open this box. It's open here. So in this box I have 12 highlighters of one color each. I can show you these are the highlighters that I have. I am more into highlighting or annotating stuff that I read, I come across. So I love to buy highlighters, and I often run out of highlighters, so I thought of why not buy different colors of highlighters. So these are the highlighters that I got, and this was a great deal considering I am getting different shades of highlighters in one box. The next item that I got is this little statue of Paris. So this is not statue of Paris, but Eiffel Tower. So I really like anything which features Eiffel Tower. I used to often keep this as my wallpaper quite some time back, and I often pin those pictures that have Eiffel Tower on it. So I have this uncanny, unusual affiliation for Paris and Eiffel Tower. So I got this small statue of Eiffel Tower, and it's really, really beautiful. Next up I have, okay, so this is mini stationery, I can call it, on the go. I've been using it for a while. It's for 10 rupees only, and you can get it in any local store. It consists of a scale, it consists of a scale, a pencil, a sharpener and a rubber. So I got this for 10 rupees. You can get this in any local store. I usually keep it handy. I used to carry a pouch of stationeries with all the necessities, the essentials, even scissors and staplers and Fevicol. But you know, of late, after giving up on corporate life, I have stopped carrying those pouches, and so I keep these kind of stationeries at home. Then I got a notebook for myself from Yuva. It is priced at 85 rupees, and it is really nice. The quality is really nice. The pattern I really liked, and I'm planning to use it for starting out my second book. Basically, what I do is I draft certain things in on book and then take it up on the laptop. So this is the notebook that I'm going to use for my second book. Next up I have is the set of bookmarks, and I don't know how much the price for this is, but it's quite cheap, guys. And in this I get four. Wait, are yaar. In these, just wow. So yeah, so I got these four help me bookmarks in this, and I really love to collect bookmarks. So this is the other things that I've got. It is available in four colors, and it's a set that you can purchase online. Then what's next? Okay, I got this pocket book post-its diary, so I can carry it in my pocket wherever I go, and I often, you know, while reading, annotate, and I often use post-its, sticking it here and there as my to-do list or to-buy list. Thing that I love the most about this post-it is that it's pocket sized and I can carry it in my purse, and because it has these flaps, cardboard flaps, if you can see these flaps, because of that, you know, there are no chances of having dog-eared post-its. So that's what I love the most. Then there are these other sets of post-its where, you know, they are patterned, and while it is quite cheap on Club Factory and Wishlist, it was little on an expensive side on Amazon, but they are really, really cool. Apart from this, I also got a Faber-Castell highlighter, and this is quite something that I use often. That's why, you know, those boxes of highlighters and even this highlighter. Apart from that, I also got these post-its. These are in three colors. These are the normal post-its that you get in any general store or stationeries. The stationeries near my house did not have many options in these, so I had to do with these. And then I also got a permanent marker in red color. Basically, using red color is often beneficial for you know, cutting off the names that I get on the couriers. And the second benefit of using red markers is that before discarding your sanitary waste, you can mark it with red marker, so that, you know, the trash pickers, they know that this is a sanitary disposed, so they can, you know, separate it. And that's the use of red marker. So I have bought this red marker for that purpose only. So that's it for today, guys. I hope my stationery haul was quite interesting. Basically, I'm not into buying anything that is not of much use to me. I know a lot of you have seen stationery hauls that are much interesting with too many things that are quite intriguing, but basically I don't like to invest in stuff that I'm not going to use. So I did not go into buying all sorts of things. I just bought those things that are advantageous to me in the long run. So that's it, and I hope you like this video, guys. I hope you like this video. Please hit the bell icon, subscribe to my channel, like and comment on my videos. If you do all of this, then you may stand a chance to win a fabulous book from my Amazon wishlist. And this month I'm supposed to give The Gospel of Judas. It's a very famous book, guys. So that's it, and see you next week with more bookish videos. Till then, bye.